that tell the people, if they love me, if they love Allah, then they have to follow you, O Muhammad. Because anyone can say, look at this verse, look at the beauty of this verse. Allahu Akbar. Anyone can say that I can love you. But true love is when you obey the one you love. True love is when you respect the one you love. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. O beloved Prophet, convey to them that obey Allah. Tell them to obey Allah and tell them to obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. And if they do not obey Allah, and if they do not obey the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he does the commentary of this verse from another verse, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that some people, they would say that you just have to obey Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. The reality is that whoever has obeyed the Messenger, then he has obeyed Allah. If you haven't obeyed the Messenger, you can never obey Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O beloved Prophet, tell them that obey the Messenger and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. And those people who do not obey, who do the total opposite of obeying Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. Then I'll tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love the kafirin. So if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you, then you have to follow who? You have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, this gathering we are gathered here in today, this is the gathering of who? Who is this gathering dedicated to? Who is this gathering dedicated to? This gathering is dedicated to no one other than Imam al-Husayn radiallahu ta'ala. Now who was Imam Husayn? Who was Imam Husayn? He was the one whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam comes down from the minbar, and when he sees Hassan al-Husayn dressed in beautiful clothing and dressed wearing robes, and who has dressed them? The leader of the women of paradise, she dresses them from home and she says that your grandfather will be delivering the speech, go and listen to the speech. As soon as they come into the masjid, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is present in the masjid, Umar radiallahu anhu is present in the masjid, Uthman radiallahu anhu is present in the masjid, Ali radiallahu anhu is present in the masjid, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carries on the speech, but when he sees Hassan Hussein, he stops the speech. And he comes down the minbar and he starts kissing them. This is the Hussein we are talking about. The one whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he is in prostration, and as you know, prostration is the most honorable deed in our salah. The highest, the most honorable deed when you read salah is the sajda. Why? Because of the level of ta'zeem you're giving to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when Hussein climbs on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prolongs and he delays and he lengthens his prostration for Hussein. Why? Because he does not want Hussein to feel discomfort. This is the Hussein we're talking about. The one whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ أَحَبَّ حُسَيْنًا. Hussein is from me, I am from Hussein. Oh Allah, love him who loves Hussein. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? If you want Allah to love you, then follow the Messenger. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's making it even easier. He's saying, Allah loves the one who loves Hussein. So those people who say, why you gather in the gatherings of Hussein? The reason why we gather is because we want an easy way out so that we can get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We get a good deal, we get a better deal. By loving Hussein, we get the better deal. Who was the grandfather of Hussein ibn Ali radiallahu ta'ala? He lengthens his prostration for him. And who is his father? Who is the father of Hussein ibn Ali radiallahu anhu? Who is his father? The one whom the Prophet ﷺ regarding said, مَنْ كُنْتُ مَوْلَاهُ فَعَلِيُّ مَوْلَىٰ. Whoever's master I am, Ali is his master. And subhanAllah, I was reading something very beautiful. I was reading the tafsir of Allama Alusi Baghdadi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And he mentions under the verse of purification, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. He mentions that Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, حُبُّ عَلِيٍ عِبَادَ. Loving Ali is عِبَادَ. And I was actually looking for a reference for this hadith. And alhamdulillah, look at the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I was reading, just before I came today, I was reading the tafsir, and I went through numerous pages, then I found this hadith written. That look at, who's saying this? Who's saying that running Ali is ibadah? Siddiqa binti Siddiq. She cannot be wrong, she can never lie. She is the daughter of the one who never lied. She says, حُبُّ عَلِيٍ عِبَادَ لَغُنْ عَلِيٍ is عِبَادَ. That is the status of the father of Hussein رضي الله. The one regarding whom the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أَنَا مَدِينَةُ الْعِلْمِ وَعَلِيٌ بَابُهَا. I am the city of knowledge, Ali is the gate of knowledge. أَنَا دَارُ الْحِكْمَةِ وَعَلِيٌ بَابُهَا. I am the house of wisdom, Ali is the gate of wisdom. The one whom the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, that no one is allowed to enter my masjid in the state of impurity except me and Ali. And Imam Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayhi says that Imam Bukhari did not know about this hadith until I told him about this hadith. Imam Tirmidhi does fakhr about this riwayah. And in fact, this is the only riwayah that Imam Tirmidhi tells Imam Bukhari rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. This is the Hussein we are talking about. Who is the mother of Hussein? The one whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-Fatima tu bada'atun minni. She is part of my flesh. The one whom regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فاطمه سيده نساء اهل الجنه. She is the leader of the women of paradise. Who is the brother of Hussein? The brother of Hussein is the one whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, inna bni hada sayyid. This my son of mine is the sayyid. He is the leader. He is the one who will reconcile my ummah. He will the one who will unite my ummah. That is the brother of Hussein. Who is the brother of Hussein? The brother of Hussein, Hassan, is the one when Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And if you want to check the statement for this, you can read up Sahih al-Bukhari of Imam Bukhari. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he comes into the house of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu. He holds Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He holds him, he clings on to him. Like we hold our young beloved babies and our young children, he holds him. And what does he say to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu? He says, Bi abi anta shabihum bin nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, I swear by my father, oh Hassan, I swear by my father that Hassan looks like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the hadith continues, the hadith. And he says to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Bi abi anta shabihum min nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That I swear that he looks like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa laysa shabihum bi aliyin. And he says that Hassan does not look like Ali. Wa aliyun yadhaku an Ali radiallahu anhu is laughing. Look at the connection between Abu Bakr and Ali radiallahu anhu. Look at the connection between Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and the love of hers for Ali. She is narrating a hadith that loving Ali is ibadah. That was the